You almost made me drop my hands. Slay by D. What's up, guys? It's Deira. I'm back with another video, and today we're vlogging. It is Monday. I just got back from the grocery store, and the struggle that was getting to my apartment. Always have something wrong with the elevators, and so I was stuck downstairs for 15 minutes just waiting on the elevators for someone to come down to let me up. Stressful. I've got ice cream, I've got frozen food, honey. Nobody has time to be waiting. I literally can't leave my apartment because if I leave, I can't get back up the elevator. I'm not taking all those stairs. Are you crazy? Anyway, let me count my blessings. I made it, y'all. I made it. So we're going to put away all my groceries. I went to Wally World, Trader Joe's, and Whole Foods. I got some frozen things because, you know, you just gotta have stuff on deck just in case. What else did I get? If y'all never tried these, honey, it's time! Okay, frozen stuff here. Focus. Now me saying Gardein who, and then I got Gardein. Oh, ice cream. I'm trying this butter pecan. It is by So Delicious, and this is caramel cluster or something like that. Okay, we got some yogurt. Alright, y'all actually probably don't care about this. I don't know. I'm just thinking. That Chick-fil-A sauce gonna hit every time. A little salsa for the babes. I ain't got nowhere to put this, child. Alright, y'all. Anyway, I thought I was going to show you guys me putting away all these groceries, but I feel like I just need to be efficient. So, I was just checking in. I love y'all. And we will pick back up tomorrow. Grand rising, beautiful people. It is Tuesday. And your girl just took an everything shower. I literally shaved my legs, did my hair, and, we're nice and moisturized. You may be asking yourself, why is her robe inside out, y'all? This is one of my favorite robes, and I lost the little tie. So now the only way it stays closed is if I do it inside out. So don't judge me, okay? I know it's inside out. She's just so cute, and so I'm not gonna get rid of her. We locked in for life, babes. Babes. Anyway, today is going to be productive day. We got a lot of stuff to get done. I need to do a deep clean on my apartment. So we got to do the bathroom, we got to do the kitchen, and I did laundry last night, but I got to fold all the towels. Literally, I love washing clothes. Folding is another beast, you know. I just don't really have the energy for all that, but I'm gonna do my best. Oh, I went grocery shopping last night, y'all saw that. But I just need to thank God for the money to pay for groceries, because that's a blessing. Y'all can't tell me God ain't good. Y'all cannot tell me my God ain't good. Blessed, okay? Blessed and highly favored. We're stacked up. And so, also got, I need to get these avocados out. Dang it. We got some fruit, we got some potatoes. Got some greens because I need to get to it. I'm gonna be trying this new Italian soda. It's blood orange and it's from Trader Joe's. And then I also got like a non-alcoholic kind of wine, but it's actually tea. And so we'll try those at some point. However, I just want to say God is good, and I'm just so grateful. I got food to eat, water to drink, clothes on my back, shoes on my feet. Yes and amen. All right, y'all. So anyway, I also need to go get my nails done. We have an appointment at 4 o'clock. It's currently 2:48. I should probably wash the dishes and do all the scrubbing and stuff before I get my nails done. So let's just work on that, shall we? Okay, I'm back really quick. I can't remember if I said this in the last vlog, but I am a girl who grew up not using the dishwasher. Okay, so we hand wash dishes throughout my whole entire childhood. And even though I've had dishwashers in multiple apartments, I just always wash my dishes. I decided to try to hand wash my dishes. I mean, use the dishwasher. And do you know it ran for like 3 hours? When I washed it, this little thing came off. Okay, yeah. And so now I feel like I need to rewash all these dishes because, like, you just wasted my time. So anyway, I'm gonna wash what's in the sink, and then I'm probably just gonna give the ones in the dishwasher a quick rinse, and then yeah, we'll go from there. But leave a comment down below, like, do y'all be using the dishwasher? Because I just feel like I'm more efficient if it's gonna run for 3 hours every time. I don't know what that was about. Let's go, shall we? Bathroom where all the work needs to be done with this cause for me putting my hair up. Not me about to make the concoction that will be the end of my days. I have a glass shower door, and so the streaks are streaking. I don't know exactly what to use, but I know we're gonna use some Comet and probably the Mr. Clean. But also have Windex, I have Myers, I have been shower cleaner, remove soap scum and hard water stains. So maybe this will work on the doors. No, we just gonna give it a go. God be with me. Jump scare. Thank you. serious when I pull off the gloves. Bro, it's serious when I pull off the gloves. Jail. Just looked at the time. It is 3:30. Now the appointment's at 4. I guess I will just have to catch the rest of this later because it's not gonna happen before this nail appointment. I'm not dressed or anything and I have so much to do. Okay, so I gotta fold my laundry. All I need to do is mop. Obviously clean my toilet. Y'all don't need to see me clean the toilet. But I do love this little situation that I have. This is so funny, but they're disposables. And so you just click it in with this little handle, and then you can click it out in the trash every time. I love to see it. I also have these little scrubble, oops, toilet, little fresheners or whatever. They smell so good. So after you clean your bathroom, then it can be nice and fresh all the time. Also, I have this little Bath and Body Works thing. I actually don't want to use this scent right now, but it's all I have. Anyway. Let me close up all these containers and get away from all these fumes before we pass out. I'll see y'all at the nail salon. We're back from the nail salon. And I picked up a few packages. Oh, by the way. Nail check, hair check, child. What is going on? Nail check. Isn't that cute? It's just like a very light pink. It's giving white on camera, but it's not white, promise. It was so hard to vlog during the nail appointment, child, because they were double speed, doing double time on my hands and feet at the same time. But this literally came just in time. Let me grab some scissors. This is nothing special, but I ordered another rug for my bathroom so that I can have both in there. I still need to mop and finish cleaning. I'm dreading this, but it will get done. Anyway, ouch. Just the small mat like the one I already have. Is this gonna be too small? Probably that. And then y'all know I'm an avid reader, child. I feel like girl math is buying books is not really, it's not really me spending money, you know? It's literally an investment into my education. I got this book called The Pivot Year, and it's by Brianna Weiss, and I love her quotes all the time on Instagram, and so I decided to invest in one of her books. I think she has quite a few, but this, honey, I just knew it was gonna be for me. It says, this is the year you change your life. If you're in a pivot period, if you're still bridging the space between where you are and where you wanna be, remember that the person you're becoming is already within you. The journey is convincing your mind to act consistently on what your heart already knows it wants to do. It's a book of 365 daily meditations on finding the courage to become who you've always wanted to be. So I am so excited. Okay, yeah. So she's written 101 essays that will change the way you think, the mountain is you, and so much more. Ah! I'm so excited. I'll let y'all know how this is. The book that I was reading about love, it's just really heavy. And so I don't always feel like reading heaviness. And so hopefully this will keep it refreshing and inspiring, and yeah, we can balance the two worlds, you know. All right, I'm just gonna knock out my cleaning, y'all. I really don't think y'all want to see me clean for 30 minutes, but maybe you do, you know. I don't know, but in efforts to spare us both so I can just get it done, I'm gonna get it done, and I will check in with y'all later. Hello, party people. The apartment is clean, finally, thank the Lord. Like, I've not seen my counter clear in ages. And I think we deserve to celebrate. I finally got my hands on the chocolate croissants from Trader Joe's. Last week, y'all, or I think 2 weeks ago, y'all saw me try to make the cheese Danish ones. I'm gonna stick to what I know. I'm going to let them proof. They have to rise overnight. So it says, place them seams down and allow uncovered croissants to sit at room temperature for 9 hours. And then they'll be ready in the morning. So it is currently 7:30. So these are so perfect for a little treat in the morning. I also have not eaten a full meal today. Shame on me. Little snack. Yesterday I bought this big salsa from Walmart. You never tried the Walmart salsa, child? Just the regular store one that they make fresh. I think they make it fresh because it doesn't have like the Great Value logo on there. Anyway, also these Siete green chili chips with a hint of lime. Not this being dinner. Girl, dinner. My mom would always buy this for the house. I don't know how I'm gonna finish this big one for just me. That's how you know I haven't ate all day. And y'all see my little flowers? They're doing so good. Look at these over here. Oh yeah, couch is made. They're thriving. I've had these for over a week. I think the trick was just adding just a teensy bit of water. I don't know, or maybe these were just a good batch. But honey, they are thriving. They're so freaking pretty. Why can't I focus on the task at hand? We're supposed to be making croissants. 7:30. That means in what, 5 hours, it'll be 12:30. So these will be ready at 4:30 a.m. Should I wait? Maybe I should wait until I'm getting ready to go to sleep. I mean, it says overnight. I'm gonna wait until I get ready to go to sleep, so then we don't have no problems. But anyway, you just set these up. I'll show y'all. Set them up, put them on the little baking tray. I have this cute pink one that y'all saw last week, and I put some parchment paper. And then, yeah, I came on, just do all that, and it's not even time. It's daylight savings, so it looks dark, but it's not late. I don't even know when I want to sleep today. Anyway, let me eat some chips and find myself something to do for the next couple hours until I can put up my croissants. Ah, you almost made me drop my croissant. Not me back again, child. Here to update y'all, and I just went to the gym. I am going to make my croissants. You almost made me drink my croissant. Just got out the gym. We're going to set these babies up. Oh, it's 9 o'clock, and they've all fallen. This is what they look like, and they are going to puff up overnight. And so, let's stack them. There's only 4. So that will be perfect. Can y'all see them? So I'm gonna leave them uncovered. and they'll puff up overnight.
Good morning, beautiful people. From me and my mighty patches, because why am I breaking out at my big old age? Seriously, so saddening, but we move. Today is Wednesday, it's about 8 a.m. And y'all, my house looks so good, I'm so proud. But look how I did the pillows this time. Is it too much? In person it doesn't look like too much, but on camera it feels a little weird. Anyway, what y'all are really here for are croissants. So I'm getting ready to preheat this oven. Let's do that. Let me set y'all down. I really need y'all to stretch your hands towards the screen right now. Pray my croissants don't burn. Because if we get a round two, I'm gonna cry. I really am. Okay, it says preheat the oven to 350. All right, girl. And then it says, bake on center rack for 20 to 25 minutes or until crisp and quite brown. Light and golden croissants will not be thoroughly baked. Cool about 10 minutes before serving. Y'all heard me. It said 20 to 25 minutes. I'll be watching it at 15. Because I listened to the directions last time. No. It just doesn't sit right with my soul that they tried to make it like I couldn't bake. That I wasn't giving Betty Crocker. So, we're going to watch this one. Mind you, it's like 8 a.m., y'all. It's way too early for me to be being this silly. But also today I'm going to curl my hair. So, we'll get into that in a little bit. But I guess it's better if I put these in first. Because my hair shouldn't take me longer than 20 minutes. But I just said I'm going to watch it, right? Dear, focus, babe, focus. I'll see y'all when the oven's preheated. But before, middle rack. I'm new here. You know, I'm just figuring out how to work this thing. Let's curl this hair, shall we?
We have very limited counter space here. Make sure this hair will start with this side. Turn this little bad boy off. Y'all, it's only been 15 minutes. Look at these croissants. They're done. Why are they saying 20, 25 minutes? That's crazy. That is quite insane if you ask me. I set the oven for 20 minutes, but I set my phone for 15. It's a setup. They want me to burn these croissants, but I'm smarter than that. They look amazing. Time to finish my hair. Let's go. Spray, and we're gonna let the curls sit, rest. We'll comb them out late set, and we'll do our edges.
Hello, you guys. I don't know when the last time was that I checked in. Y'all, I tore that croissant up. It was so delicious. Sorry for all the noise. I have no idea what's going on. Anyway, I have a guest coming into town for a few days, and so that is why I was deep cleaning my apartment and just getting everything nice and ready. I don't know how much I'm gonna vlog, however,
I will check in as frequently as I feel necessary, but if I'm gone for a few days, just know I was entertaining my guest, and I will check in with you guys definitely before the end of the vlog. So I will see you guys when I see you, but I'll give you a quick outfit check.
Hair looks gorge. Little dress.
And curls by me. Slay by D. All right, y'all. I love you. I'm so annoyed with the noise, but I'm trying my best to just stay cool, calm, collected. I'll see y'all later. Good morning, guys. I just made it to the doctor's office, hoping to get released to get back to work this week. I'm just updating y'all really quick, but hopefully I'll get back there in a couple minutes. My appointment's at 8, it's 7:57, so wish me luck. Oh, I'm so tired. Y'all, this has been going on for so many months. Just ready to be done. Appointment was at 8:30. Finally leaving Concentra. I told them today to release me back to work because they're not being helpful. And I just didn't feel comfortable doing the surgery, especially through them. But the doctor was nice, so basically I'll be on supportive care, but I'll be able to return to work. And now I can actually just go through my primary care doctor. I got a release of records, and so I'm just gonna move forward with it on my own if need be, but they would definitely not be cutting me open. I just felt like the fact that the last appointment was 3 weeks ago, they requested a MRI, then I got there today, and they're like, oh, did you get your MRI? You don't know that I didn't get the MRI because y'all didn't send all the paperwork. Like, just, that's such a small thing compared to all the frustration I've had transitioning. But anyways, I'm going to look at the bright side and be excited. At least I get to go back to work, and hopefully things will continue to get better and my arm will heal on its own. But yeah, for all y'all who ask, am I still employed? Am I still a flight attendant? Yes, I am. And so I will sprinkle a little flight attendant content in there for y'all as I get back going to work. So there's our update for the day. I'm going to take it easy and just rest and recoup. So I'll see y'all. Hello, party people. Can y'all see me? Can you hit that switch? We're making cookies from scratch because, what do we celebrate? I'm celebrating going back to work. So we're gonna make some cookies. Y'all, today has been productive. I went bowling earlier and got beat so bad. Bowling and what? Connect Four, Jenga. I lost that at all. So anyways, we're gonna make some cookies and then I'm gonna show y'all what they look like. If you didn't know, if you wanna make cookies from scratch, all you gotta do is follow the recipe on the back of the bag. So it has butter, sugar, brown sugar, flour, baking soda, vanilla extract, and 2 eggs. Am I missing anything? Salt, and that's it. Easy peasy, and they're gonna be amazing. So I'll show y'all what they look like.
Look at her. Huh. Look at the woman, man. Look at her. Huh. That ain't my girl. That's my nigga.
We just finished the cookie dough. It looks amazing. Thanks to my sous chef. Because it's already late, we're gonna go ahead and make some, but the rest of the dough will just go in here so it can set. It's better to let it chill and then bake, but we're gonna eat.
Whichever one is in a household. Oh, damn, yeah, man. Oh, never knew, no, I never knew that you'd be a freak and a friend, too. Yeah, you into everything I'm into. Oh. I got something that I could lend you. A peace of mind, baby. Come and get a peace of mind. Say you gotta work from 3 to 9.
Where the hell did they go? 10 minutes. You paying attention? Miss Betty Crocker with the trap in the back. Okay, the reason I'm taking them out now is because they're still gonna cook on the pan, okay? Don't want dark cookies, those are already too dark. Also, you wanna try this little thing? Apparently, this makes them round. See? It's so hot. It gets so hot. Look at me. Is this camera on? It gets hot, so you gotta be careful. But y'all see what it does. It gets them round. So we're gonna make all of them perfect, and then we're gonna enjoy them. So yeah, making cookies from scratch is easy. Y'all, cookies are done. Look how cute they are. Now we're gonna have some ice cream. This is a brand called So Delicious. I've never tried the butter pecan, but my mom loves butter pecans. Shout out to mom. And then this is salted caramel clusters. So hopefully it's good, but that's it. We're gonna have cookies and ice cream and relax for the rest of the night. Good morning, beautiful people. Happy Saturday. It's currently 9 something and we're getting ready to go to a yoga class. I am so excited. I hope it's beginner friendly. This is our little outfit. We're just gonna wear all black. Of course, we're wearing our Wildly Written tee, babes. And I just cropped it up a little bit to give a little yogi vibe. Show a little abs, do a little dance, get down to the heights. Anyway, just checking in. Let's get going, shall we?
Left hand towards the block, stretch your right arm high, and then start to lean. This time, ground it in, both palms lift up, and then ground into your palms by tabletop. So move all the way to the floor, knees and palms towards the earth. Dip your belly down, tilt your tailbone up, take your gaze with you, breathing. Exhale into that calf, or chin the chest, don't pull your upper back. So push the earth away and then slow that. Inhale, pull your chest through. So big movement, circle out through your wrist, open towards the daylight. And then thread the needle through. So right hand will go underneath your body, right ear towards the earth, and slowly into your left palm back under your shoulder, and then open it back up, move towards the side of the middle, lift up. Arch your palm up towards the left side of your space. Circle it around, move it around. Then thread it through. When you're ready, left ear towards the mat, left palm faces up. Let it drop all the way down. And then option extend your right arm forward for more lateral body stretch. You can find it back behind you. Nice and strong. Start to push your hips high, high down dog. As you press back, let your hips lift towards the ears behind you. Take your time if you want to pedal out through your feet. Or elevate your heels. Exhale, hover your knees. Good. Inhale, hips to the sky. Exhale, melt your heels down.
Y'all, I just finished yoga. This morning was so beautiful. Like, that was just such a great way to start the day. The weather's so nice. I mean, it's really wet out here though because it's been raining in Phoenix. Just to think that the beginning of 2023 is so drastically different from how I'm ending 2023. I was a little heartbroken, a lot of stressed. I moved to a new city. My life was falling apart. My apartment was horrendous. Like, I just was having issue after issue. My car broke down. I hurt my arm. I was literally incapable of working. Now, I've moved back to Phoenix. I live in like a beautiful, luxurious apartment with great amenities. I'm healthy, I'm happy, I'm not heartbroken. I have so much vitality and strength, and I'm working out, I'm doing good for myself. I'm repairing relationships with my siblings and my family. Like, it's just a 180 for sure. Chef's kiss. 10 out of 10 would recommend healing your life and being in alignment and trusting God and trusting the process. So. Y'all, I stumbled upon a farmer's market. How cute.
These are perfect on the go snacks. They don't melt at all, so if you like to get them really hot.
If you ever see Urge Sugar.
Thank you, ladies.
All right, we're on a mission. I met two girlies, Brittany and Lindsay. You want to say hi?
Hey!
Y'all, we out here. I love this for me. I literally set a goal to make more friends in like the wellness space. So
manifest that.
So good.
Absolutely, right. And so we're going to find some burritos, I think, and then maybe a little acai bowl. I'm ready to give them all my money. I'm so hungry.
I only have a card, too.
Should I weigh this?
Yes, please. Okay, it's gonna be $2.34.
Lovely.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Happy Thanksgiving to you.
Take care.
You too. Oh, we wanna rock. Don't do electric
avenue. And then we'll take it higher. Hi, how are you? No, so I'll make it look cool for you guys.
I made it back home, and it is time to dive into this burrito. I put my little smoothie bowl in the freezer because I need some sustenance first. Oh, I'm so excited. I literally met those two girls at yoga right now, and it's just so beautiful because we love making friends. Oh, this looks amazing. So I just got a breakfast burrito. It's eggs, potatoes, beans, and cheese, I think. Now it's such a beautiful day. I just feel like Phoenix is that girl. Hey y'all, it is later Saturday night, and guess what? We're supposed to be out celebrating for my sister's birthday, and she canceled. And so we're all doing that, and I just threw on a simple outfit. We're still gonna hit the town and make the most of this night. This is my outfit, my little cute little black staple. Anyway, I'm checking in because I'm just like, what the heck? How did I invite people to your celebration? You cancel, and now I still gotta go out. I could have gladly stayed at home watching movies on my projector, watching 90 Day Fiancé reruns. Like, I am such a homebody. Anyway, we look cute. I'm loving this little fall lip combo. This is just NYX products. Mind you, my skin is breaking out so bad, so to get a cute little beat is making me feel a lot better. We're very much contoured, honey. We're blushed up, double cheeked up on a Saturday. Anyway, Alexis is on her way, and we're gonna paint the town. And I don't know how much I'm gonna record because I'm not bringing this camera, but if I can catch the vibes, I will, y'all. If not, please forgive me. Just know I don't want to go out anyway, so you're probably not missing much. But we look cute, we look cute doing it. So I'll check in with y'all tomorrow. Bye. Hello, beautiful people. It is Sunday. My goodness. I am all dressed, getting ready to finally go out to my sister's birthday because this girl has been busy all weekend. I guess she's been changing plans left and right, honey, and I couldn't keep up. So finally today we're getting ready to link up. I'm so excited. Happy birthday, Fanny. I love you. If you made it this far into the video, please just know that I appreciate you being here and watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and if you haven't already, subscribe. Leave some love in the comments. I just want to hear from y'all. I want to know that y'all are enjoying the videos. I want to know if y'all are liking the consistency, if y'all are appreciating it. I'm going to try to switch up the content a little bit, so just stay tuned. If you see something that's not a weekly vlog, still tune in, see if you're feeling it, if you like it, and you know, leave some feedback.